Today I'm going to show you some of the apps that I use on a daily basis. All of them are powered by SetApp. It's a membership and you can find my referral link in the description. Now, SetApp, the membership, gives you access to curated apps for Mac, Web and iOS. Write, design, code, plan, collab, clean or protect. Think of a task you'd like to complete and just open SetApp. Search apps by task, install and get things done. You have 240 plus apps to choose from. So let's see my favorites. Today I'm going to show you my favorite 8 apps from SetApp. They all come with this subscription. It's really nice. And plus some hundreds of more. Now, the first one is Clean My Mac X. So if you have system junk, mail attachment and trash bin that you want to take care of, or maybe some malware remover, privacy. You can also optimize and have some maintenance, as you can see, uninstall, update apps, extensions manager, remove large and old files, shredder. It's really, really a comprehensive cleaner for your Mac. You can just add it to your arsenal and just use it along all of the other apps. Now, this is my favorite, most favorite, because it frees up space and gives speed to my Mac. My second one is Bartender. I don't know if you have noticed, but my bar right over here is, the menu is like not really cluttered. You can see we have just a few icons right over here. Now, if you are not using Bartender, this might not be your case. If you aren't, you might have something like this. As you can see, there are a lot of stuff right over here. So basically what this does is just moves away all of this clutter, and you can just, of course, click over here and it will just appear. You can set all of these things up, but it's really, really nice, so you don't have this visual clutter. Free on the list is CLEANSHOT X. Now, this is a menu bar application. It's right over here, and you can capture screenshots, recordings, all in one, capture an area, capture previous area if you are that, capture full screen window. This is really amazing, like scrolling capture. So you just select an area and then you start the capture and you can just scroll and we just make this really, really long capture. Self timer, text, record a screen, show or hide desktop icons, which I use very, very often. And basically you can just have a capture history, and it's really, really versatile for capturing. I use this quite a lot. Now, fourth is the very own software that we are recording this video with, and that is called CAPTO. You can see here it is, it's just blinking, and it's super nice. You can just capture the whole screen. You can, as you can see, it's just stop and save recording, pause the recording, cancel the recording. Let me just jump into a setup so you can see a little bit more about it. So this is the setup app that you are going to download, and here you can find all of your applications. Let's just go on this map and go to CAPTO. Here we go. Let's just double click on it. And here you can see some nice screenshots of how it actually looks like. It's really, really versatile. I've been using CAPTO for years now to record my YouTube videos. Okay, next up is MOUCHUUUPS Studio. Now, of course, if you are an iOS developer, you want to have some mockups to show your views that you have created your application. So this is really, really versatile. So you can just choose by device, hands, orientation, if it's transparent, and you can scroll all the way down and select one, and then you can just add in your image, and that's it. It's just as simple as that. Six is PULLTUBE. Now, most probably you know that you do need a subscription for YouTube to be able to download the videos. Now, all you have to do is just paste in your URL for the video, and then you can just either download the full video or download MP3.
It's really, really a nice if you want to take your videos with you where, you know, you don't have internet access. Number seven is a GIFOX. Now, this is a GIF creator. And let me just open it up, GIFOX. And what it does, it lives on the menu bar right over here. And what you can do is capture GIFs from an area or from a window, and you just also store it right over here. You can go to the library where it's storing it. It's really, really nice to make short animated GIFs. It's really, really powerful. And finally, number eight, of course, if you are an iOS developer, you want to have an app icon creator, and that's what my final favorite app is. It's called Asset Catalog Creator. You just drag and drop your image right over here. It basically should be 10 24 by 10 24, yes, and you can just select size variations, batch export, or a single image, then select iOS app icon, launch screen, all of these options. The directory where this asset catalog should be created, and then just click on update asset catalog, and that's it. As simple as that. You have now your icons ready. Now, hope you enjoyed all of these. They are available actually on setup.com. Go ahead and check out the referrer link down in the description if you want to support this channel. And if you do like these types of videos and you want me to make some more, go ahead and hit that like button and also subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next one.